Hey, what's going on YouTube? I'm back, Air Force Shields. Got another pickup video for you. These are all the pickups, well, not all of them. It's just a highlight of some of the stuff that I picked up in August. Just want to do a short, quick video. Usually put out about two videos a month, but been kind of lazy lately. Been trying to catch a lot of gameplay, and so I haven't had a lot of time to be on YouTube or comment on stuff. So hopefully everybody got their package with the 1,000 subscriber video. Let me know if you have not, and I'll get back to you. But let me show you what I got for the month of August. It's a highlight of some of the things, and we'll go from there. So one of the first things I found, it was pretty funny. There's a bookstore I go to in my local area, and they always have everything in the store is for a dollar. So usually I always go there once in a blue moon. I'm always picking up children's books for my kids and stuff like that. And always check out the game section, see if they have any strategy guides. And they had some this time. I picked up some good ones. Three of them I did. I picked up a Game Boy's player guide. Pretty cool. It was funny, I was looking through this and looking at some of the games that were released for the Game Boy. And pretty funny, some of the footage in there. Another one I picked up was Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. That was there. Pretty good. This one's kind of beat up though, but still it'll get the job done when I use it to play the game. I already beat Majora's Mask, but if I decide to run through it again, I'm sure there's going to be some stuff in there that I have missed, and I'll be able to you know, find out and make it happen and be able to complete the game 100%. And the last one, and I was shocked about the condition of this, it was the Final Fantasy strategy guide, and this one is in mint condition, as you can see, barely ever used. And it's funny, I was reading inside, this was when this was sent out in 1992, and it's still in this condition. So I looked around to see if they had any more strategy guides. Like, I know Nintendo released a few. I know they did one for one of the Castlevania games, I think Ninja Gaiden 2. They did one in a couple other games, so I was hoping to look for it, but that's the only one I found. So, alright, let me go to a couple other stuff I have here. Like I said, you know my videos always go all over. I go all over the place. I don't go in any particular order, so I'm just going to grab what I have and show you what I got. I picked up some good stuff for the PlayStation, and let me get right to it. Galaga Destination Earth, which is a pretty cool game. This game I was looking for a long time. R-Types. I love the R-Type series, and this is a great game to have for the PlayStation 1. Tomba 2, which is pretty fun. I like the first one better, but it wasn't bad. Not a bad game, but the first one to me is better. And Elemental Gear Bolt. And pick these games up for a good price. Good price from all on retailer, so. Let me go over some other stuff I found. Found this one. Very hard to find this game out there complete. Masters of the Universe. I've always wanted to play it, and not disappointed with it at all. It's a pretty cool game. And like I said, it's hard to find and complete in this condition. So got it for a good deal. Also, Metal Gear Solid for the Game Boy Color. Both of those are complete, and I haven't had a chance to play Metal Gear Solid, but hey man, if you're definitely out there and you see that game, see it loose, just go ahead and definitely pick it up. It's a very good game. One random game I found also was Mutant Rampage Body Slam for the CDI. I know my boy Syphic usually plays the CDI game, so I'll be definitely sending this his way next time I see him. So I don't have a CDI. Really don't have a desire to have a CDI. I still need to catch up on so much stuff, but if I see one for cheap, I'll pick it up. But no desire for this game, and I will pass them on to Syphic. So let me see what else. Another game I've always wanted, and this is Ninja Gaiden or Gaiden 3, whatever you want to pronounce it. I got this through a trade from my boy Northern Light 777. He sent me some other stuff via trade, and I traded him some stuff too, but this was the highlight of it. So again, I appreciate it. I noticed some games are still looking out there for, and I'm out to look out for them too. So if I see them, I will holler at you and let you know. But again, thanks again for Ninja Gaiden 3. Okay, let me continue to go through the stack. I got this from a local video game store. It was $5.95. I think it was a mispriced. Grandia 2 for the PlayStation 2. Also got some Xbox games that I needed. Alias. Pitfall, The Lost Expedition, which was very fun. SX Superstar. Special Forces Nemesis Strike. And the last one, Frogger Ancient Shadow. So, I might have to, I'll probably do it sometime this next weekend coming up and check, but I gotta see how many Xbox games I have. Every week I'm finding games out there, but I haven't counted to see how many I have, so. Let you know next video I do. Let me get into, let me see what else I have here. Goodwill pickup I found. Magna Carta, Tears of Blood, and this is the deluxe box set in good condition. Usually when I find this game out there in a while, the outer box is usually kind of beat up, but this is actually one that was in better condition, and this was a Goodwill pickup. The only thing I found from Goodwill in August, so like you guys know out there, Goodwills are drying up. There's a lot of people out there doing what I do, so usually I find a lot more Goodwills, but lately it's just, you know, nothing. So another game I found, online retailer, Banjo-Kazooie. This is complete for a good price. And some Super Nintendo games I found. Darius Twin, good game. I already had this game, but I couldn't pass up on the price, and it was complete, so the game, I had a copy of it. It was this box, only the box was beat up. The game was mint though, so found a complete copy, happy about that. And also Rival Turf complete. This is a very, very good beat 'em up game. If you never had a chance to try this on the Super Nintendo, definitely go pick it up. It's a good game. I love it. It kind of plays along the same lines. It's kind of like a Final Fight, Streets of Rage type of game. But yeah, this game was very, very fun. I remember playing this with one of my friends back in high school a lot of times. It's a pretty, pretty fun game. So if you see it out there, definitely pick it up. Okay. Let me see here, and then I found some Nintendo. Like I said, it's getting harder and harder to find Nintendo games complete in the box, and a lot of these games, I'm usually not seeking out complete Nintendo games, but usually if I see them out there, I'm usually not going to pass on them. So all these games I either got via swap meet or via cheap eBay buy now price, all these games. So first one is Legacy of the Wizard. This game's usually cheap anyways, complete in box, but the price is really good, so I didn't pass it up. Tailspin. And I usually love all the Capcom Disney games, but that was the one I really didn't like or really couldn't get into. Dragon Spirit. Double Dragon 2. Castlevania 2, Simon's Quest, and now that I have all the Castlevanias for the NES complete in box, so this is the last one I needed. And Dragon Warrior. I remember Dragon Warrior. I originally got Dragon Warrior when I subscribed to Nintendo Power back in the day. Nintendo Power had a deal where if you sign up, I think, for a year subscription, you get this and a strategy guide for free, so. Definitely a very good game. If you never played that, definitely check it out. And last one, Elevator Action. Only bad thing about this one is there's a rip in the back of it. But still complete in good condition. And last but not least, some Sega pickups I got. These are the highlights of the games I found. Transbot. Found it on eBay Snipe for a very good price. Astro Warrior. This was a Swift thrift store fine for this. It was cheap. And then some Genesis games that I needed and always wanted to play. Crossfire, complete. I haven't played any of these Genesis games yet because I'm going to add to my backlog. I'm still stuck on a couple of 360 games that I'm playing. Earthworm Jim. Risky Woods, which looks pretty cool. Can't wait to play this one. Trampoline Terror. Cid of Alice. And what's funny about this one, I found this one back in the day, but the label was messed up. It was a rental, it was a former rental, This one's pretty clean, and got it for an outstanding deal. Cheaper than the version, cheaper than the one that I found that was all messed up. Contra Hard Corps. This game is getting very expensive. I was shocked to see this game's going for 50, 60 bucks on online, which is ridiculous. So got it cheap. And then last one was Outrun 2019. So all that stuff, those are the highlights from August. Like I said, I've been cutting back on a lot of my YouTube time, but I just really haven't had a lot of time with family, school, work, and just trying to catch up on games. So next week I'll try to put out the stuff I found for mid-month September, the stuff I found for the 1st or the 15th of September. I'll try, no promises, but I should be able to get that one out next week. Again, thank you for everybody for watching these videos, commenting, subscribing. I will get back into commenting, placing comments back on my videos soon, very soon. But I'm sorry, I haven't been able to the past couple videos I put out there. I haven't replied to a lot of comments. I've been very busy, so hopefully I will be able to in the near future. And like I said, again, thank you for watching these videos, and like I said, keeping YouTube enjoyable, something, and something that I want to watch. I haven't seen a lot of videos lately about people, I don't know, it's been a lot of bragging, or I got this for this price, or this person, you know. So that's why lately I've stopped saying how much I got something for. If it's a good, I'll just tell you if I got it for a good price or not. And like I said, it seems like it's more of a competition now than I'm seeing on YouTube. And I was having a conversation with one person that inspired me to be on YouTube, and this person's about to leave YouTube probably for good because of just the stuff going on. And there's a lot of, you know, people bragging about this or that, or shady deals going on, or people, you know, putting a thumb down on a video because they disagree with one thing you say, but they don't realize the hard work you put in for videos and stuff like that. So it's kind of changing. So that's why I really haven't had a lot of time, or really haven't focused on YouTube like I used to. So hopefully I'll get back into it. You know, maybe things will change. But in the meantime, hope you enjoyed this video. And again, thank you for watching. I'll put up a video of the stuff I found mid-month. Stuff I found from the 1st to 15th very, very soon. Again, take care. And 1,000 subscribers, if you didn't get your packages yet, please let me know. I just want to make sure. I have a tracking number for all those packages. I know, I think one person got it because I saw he posted a picture of it. But if anybody else who haven't got it yet, please let me know. Take care, and I'll see you on a future video.